Welcome to another edition of Frank and Friends, and I tell you, I'm the fortunate one to always meet new friends, but this is a first. This is not only a friend, this is actually family. This is Pastor Chris Shelton from Arkansas, and the wild thing is we connected through Facebook through a mutual friend, Eric Fuller, my dear buddy from Texas, who's formerly from Piggott, Arkansas, and I knew the last name, but I had no idea that there was a connection, and we found out that our relatives... I knew my family had come from England and came to the D.C. area, and there was a splintering off, and some went down to Virginia, to Kentucky, to Missouri. And what's wild is Chris not only loves the Lord, he's a former FBI agent. He's done a little bit of everything, and there's that long lineage of law enforcement even in my family. And here he is now full-time in ministry. They graciously had me preach about 2 years ago at their church in Arkansas, and it just took off, and then we were able to, their son Adam went with us to Praise Fest Ministry, Cruise with the Calls to Jamaica, and then God used this goofball to reconnect y'all with Ronnie Dean, the preacher machine, and our dear friend Metalark Lemon, and you guys have hosted Metalark at several events, but Chris is also an author, he's a preacher, but more importantly, he's a reacher. So Chris, just tell them in a nutshell what Jesus means to you.
Well, I got to tell you, I'm so grateful. I spent over 10 years working in Child Protective Services, and that is a ministry.
Amen.
But God put it on my heart that the state can help, but only God can heal. And he sent me to ministry school, and then he put it on my heart to write a book. It's Okay with My Father, a Child Abuse Investigator's Call to the Church. And these are cases that I was involved in, but I don't get graphic. I don't identify anybody, but it just ties in where the church can be involved. And with 1 in 4 girls being molested before adulthood and 1 in 6 boys, we need to be doing something to make a difference.
Amen.
And you know, one of the things I think is so cool, and I love how God works, you know, we found out that while I was serving as a counterintelligence special agent in the Washington, D.C. area, in the Capitol, your father was serving on as the chief of the Capitol Police. And I got to tell you, at the time, I did not realize why I got the special treatment I did. But we even later found out that we were both at Stand in the Gap in 1997.
Right.
Both standing in front of the old Smithsonian building at the same time.
Wow.
So you just love how God works.
Amen. Well, it's an honor to be a Christian. It's an honor to be an American. But no joke, I've been the fortunate one to be a Shelton. It's just, we try to live a life of integrity. And we got a lot to live up to. But God is so good. And I'm so proud about your book. And I'm honored that you asked me to write the foreword.
Yep.
And guys, I would encourage everybody, if you get a chance, buy 10 of them. One for yourself and 9 to give away, and they'll bless you. And Chris's son, Adam, is somebody I look up to, not only because of his height, but because of the way he walks with heaven. Come on in here, Chris. And Adam came with us, and this brother, preaching and praising, and he's a phenomenal praise and worship. What a powerful testimony. And in a nutshell, tell them what happened that one day with the accident.
Well, what happened was I lost my ear in a car accident. And then through everything and through the surgeries, I saw angels above my mom and my dad.
Man.
And one put their hand on my shoulder. And it was crazy because there's just like beings of pure light. And then they said, this is going to be your testimony. And this is going to set you apart and make you unique to reach people.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's just phenomenal that God would choose me and love me like that. To
Amen.
God, you lost an ear that others could hear his message through you. Only God should do that. Amen.
Yeah.
Well, man, I love you guys. You have a long trip. I had the privilege to preach this past week in Columbus, Georgia. And we're at the television station right now in Phoenix City, Alabama. And I shout out to our selfless saint, Tony Workman. And Tony, God used Tony Workman running the camera to literally allow us to be on the camera more ways than one. This is Tony's radio television program that these two guys just filmed, and I had the privilege to be a guest in the past, and we're getting ready to tape again today. But Tony, your reward is going to be huge, and anyways, we're proud of you. But guys, just in 30 seconds, Pastor Chris, if you could leave a viewer today who may be down, discouraged, defeated, considering throwing in the towel, what would you give them with to inspire them?
I'm going to reach over. One of the things that my son didn't get a chance to say in that quick testimony is, we had given him this Bible as a gift when he graduated high school, and he loved it. It's his favorite Bible, and I guess it was prophetic, but we had written in there, with love from your mom and dad, a seed into your future ministry. We didn't know what was going to be happening, but he carried this with him everywhere he went. When he had the accident, I was right up there in the scene, and with my background, we made sure he was taken care of. But then I was out looking for his ear, and I wasn't able to find his ear, but I was able to find his Bible. But when I found it, it was covered in mud and blood, glass. It had been damaged. It had been torn. It was coming apart. And I knew my son loved this, and it broke my heart because I know that when he saw it, he was going to be crushed. And when he saw it, I saw in his eyes, he thought there was nothing we could do but throw it out. And I said, no. I said, that's your blood on that Bible, and that makes it precious to me, and there's no way we're going to throw that out. But what I did, and what he didn't know, is while he was recovering, I took the Bible and I carefully started cleaning it. And I had to do it very slowly, because if you did it too fast, you'd do more damage. But I had to slowly clean the dirt off, and I had to clean the mud off, and I had to re-glue the pages back together and work oil into it. And the thing is that's what God does in our lives. The world might say that you're damaged, you're covered in dirt, there's nothing to do but throw you away. But God says, when my son's blood on here is on you, you're precious to me. And we're not going to throw you out. And he's going to take the time to clean you and work the oil into you and go page by page, because he's got a good plan for your life. And I've had grown men bust into tears when I tell them, God loves you and he's got a good plan for your life. And that's what I'll leave you with, is God loves you and he's got a good plan for your life. And just like this Bible, he's got that plan for your life.
Amen. And just like that Bible had his blood all in it, the blood of Jesus Christ is what separates. His blood is all through that book. Because without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. And in a nutshell, Muhammad didn't bleed for you. Confucius didn't die for you. I'm telling you, Jesus Christ shed his blood for you. And if you were the only person in the world, Christ would have died for you. Mm-hmm. So the word of the day is, when you're down to nothing, God, Jesus is up to something. God bless you, and go with God.
I love you guys.
I love you. Love you, buddy. Family and friends, faith goes a long ways. Peace out.